The man responsible for the Voodoo Music Festival is now facing up to 25 years behind bars. This after police say he raped a woman. Tonight, festival producer Stephen Rehage is out on bond after being booked at Orleans Parish Prison on a rape charge.
WDSU News reporter Tiffany Bradley is here now with the details on this case. Tiffany?
Less than a week after the 12th Voodoo Experience concluded, Stephen Rehage, the festival's founder and producer, was jailed on accusations that he raped a woman he went on a date with during the summer.
Stephen Rehage is well known for hosting some of the largest festivals in the Crescent City, including being the founder of the Voodoo Music Festival. He is now accused of drugging, choking, and raping a woman after a date on June 21st.
It happened in June. The night that it happened, her boyfriend called the police to go to the house where she was over there with Mr. Rehage after they had had dinner and drinks together, many drinks. When the police arrived on the scene, she made no complaint of being raped.
Rehage's attorney, Pat Fanning, says the accusations are false. According to police reports obtained by the Times-Picayune, the woman says after having drinks with Rehage, she lost consciousness and woke up naked in a bed with Rehage on top of her, choking her. Those same reports say the woman's toxicology test shows she had two prescription drugs in her system. She told police she didn't take any drugs.
Police came to Mr. Rehage's house, and we allowed them to search his house, and they found no Darvon at his house.
Fanning says the woman is a veterinarian and could have written the prescription herself. The police report also says a sexual assault did occur. That's when officers obtained an arrest warrant for Rehage.
He has never been arrested in his life. He's 46 years old, and he should not have been arrested today. He's not guilty of any crime. He intends to vigorously defend against these charges, and we expect that he'll be vindicated at the end of these proceedings.
In fact, on the night in question, Fanning says police made no arrest and conducted no investigation and gave the alleged victim a ride home.
Now here we are 5 months later and she's saying she was raped.
Now police haven't said why so much time passed between when the victim reported the rape and Rehage's arrest. Camille.